boys and girls. So we are starting our brand new math book. We are starting module 14 today, and we'll be doing lesson 14.1. And our I can statement is, I can describe, build, and draw three-dimensional shapes. So three-dimensional shapes are shapes that you can actually pick up. There are five three-dimensional shapes that we're going to be working on today, and these are the five. Going to be talking about cubes, spheres, and I put a little F down here to help you remember that S-P-H sounds like an F, so sphere, rectangular prisms, cylinders, and in cylinder, the C has the soft S sound, so cylinder sounds like an S instead of a C, so I put a little S down there to remind you of that, and then cone. Those are the five types of three-dimensional shapes that we're going to be working on. So we'll be talking about them as I pick them up, and I think you can have fun doing the same activity if you have time at home. Rufus wants to help with math today. Hi, Rufus. Do you want to help sort shapes today? So you can find things around your house and see and do a little sort, and if you want to, you can send me a little picture. That would be great fun. So I'm just going to pick up shapes here and there and help you figure out what they are. So here's our first shape. This one has squares on every side. If I count them, they're actually six squares. So this is just like a dice. And I think most of you know, name this shape if you know what it is. Say it out loud at home. It's a cube, and a cube has to have six squares. So if I look through my table, I'm gonna see if I can grab, just to save time, a couple of other cubes. This is a cube. And this one's a cube. We may find more as time goes by, but these three are all cubes. I'm gonna set them behind my label for cube. Let's talk about another shape. So this shape, this is my coffee container. Dunkin' Donuts, my favorite, has a circle on the top, a circle on the bottom, and then it's wrapped with a curved surface. So it has two flat sides. The circles are both flat, and then a curved side around. And this is called a cylinder. Cylinder. So if I look through my table at some of my other shapes, this Vicks container, let's check it. It has a circle on the top, a circle on the bottom, a curved surface all around, two flat surfaces, and one curved. This is also, say it with me, it's a cylinder. If I look through my table, there are several other cylinders. This candle looks like a short, fat one compared to this one, but they're the same shape. It has a circle on the top, a circle on the bottom, and a curved surface all around. These all three are cylinders. How about this box? So the box reminds me a little bit of the cube in that it has all flat sides or flat surfaces. There are no curved surfaces on this box. But not all of them are squares. If I look at some of these sides, actually all of them are not squares, they're rectangles. And if any of the sides are rectangles, it's a rectangular prism. So a cube has to be all squares. A rectangular prism has rectangles. So I can look at my baking soda box. It has rectangles, all flat surfaces. It's a rectangular prism. My cake box, rectangular prism. And even this little shape. It has rectangles on four sides. It does have squares on the ends, but because some of the sides are rectangles, it's a rectangular prism. Put it right over here behind rectangular prism. Let's look at some more shapes. This one is hard to find in my house. Actually, I found two that are exactly the same, and they're the only ones I have. I didn't have any ice cream cones. Oh, I have some foam ones, I think. You're right. I do have some foam ones that I brought home from school. Actually, this one looks like a student bit the end off of it, but all of these are cones. Now, cones technically have to have a circle on one end, so the hats don't exactly fit. They have to have a flat circle on one end and then a curved surface. So they're kind of like the cylinder. Remember, the cylinder had two circles and a curved surface. The cone just has one circle and a curved surface. So that's the difference between a cone and a cylinder. So that's a tricky thing. They'll ask you that in your book. So cone has one curved surface and the point at the top. Cylinder has two curved surfaces. So let's put these cones over on the back of my table. I didn't need much room for them because I don't have any of them. Those are cones. And that's an easy one to remember because of ice cream cones. So let me pick up a couple of other shapes. What about this one? It's not a circle, boys and girls. A lot of people want to call this a circle. A circle is a two-dimensional shape. It's something you can draw on a piece of paper. If you can pick it up, it's not a circle. This is a sphere. This is a sphere. So a marble, a tennis ball, a soccer ball, a basketball, all spheres. And that's the one with the PH. So sphere, sphere. And they are hard to put in place because they roll around. Let's see if we get this to stay on the table. All right, let's sort some more shapes. I'm going to grab a few. We've now seen every group. So I'm going to grab one, and I want you to say what it is. Circle on the top, circle on the bottom, curved surface all around. What is that? It's a cylinder. If you said cylinder, you were correct. Circle on the top, circle on the bottom, curved surface all around. It's a cylinder. Remember, cylinder is the one that starts with a C. Cylinder. Soxy. All right, this one has some weird shapes on it, but overall, it's a ball, so it's a sphere. I'm going to grab a couple of other balls. A tennis ball. Sphere. A yellow foam ball. Sphere. So let's put these over here. Grab some more shapes. How about my can of beans? Circle on the top, circle on the bottom also, curved surface all around. It's a, see if you can say it before me, it's a cylinder. Same thing with my enchilada sauce. Circle on the top, circle on the bottom, curved surface all around. It's a cylinder. I found lots of cylinders at my house. See if you can find a lot of cylinders too. I found some little tiny cylinders. Chapstick, glue stick, circle on the top, circle on the bottom, curved surface all around. These are also cylinders. How about this game box? Rectangle, 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 six of them, all flat surfaces. What is it? It's a rectangular prism. Rectangular prism. That's the only one that has two words in it. All right. Circle on the top, circle on the bottom, curved surface around the outside. These are both cylinders. And I'm looking through my row. This is kind of a silly one. Circle on the top, circle on the bottom, curved surface. A marshmallow is kind of a squished cylinder also. I told you I found a lot of those in my house. Lots of cylinders. All right, what are the balls? Say it before I do. It's a sphere. Rectangles all the way around. All six sides, all flat surfaces, no curved surfaces. What is it? A rectangular prism. And my book. Basically, rectangle, 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 six rectangles, all flat surfaces. A book is essentially a rectangular prism as well. I found this block, rectangular prism. This one is kind of like one of the other ones. It does have two squares on the ends, but not all of the sides are square. but it would be a special kind of rectangular prism called a cube, which we'll get into that a little bit too, because technically cubes are also rectangular prisms, but in first grade we don't talk a whole lot about that. All of these that I have in my hands are rectangular prisms. Rectangular prism. A few more quick shapes here. This tile I picked up from our Quirkle game. It does have a square on the top, a square on the bottom, but if you look carefully at the sides, these are rectangles. So it's not a cube, it's technically a rectangular prism. Same with your sticks, you all have these at home. This side is a rectangle, rectangle, rectangle. The ends are squares, but because the four of the sides are rectangles, rectangular prism. Just a few more to go. Circle on the top, circle on the bottom, curved surface all around the sides. These are, say it before I do, ready? What is it? It's a cylinder. I didn't realize I had so many cylinders. Oh, here's another one, right? Circle, circle, curved, cylinder. How about this? It's a ball, so it's a sphere. Two more, and they're both the same. Square on every side, just like a dice. Ignore this little bump on that side. These are both cubes. So, search your house, name some of the shapes you find, say goodbye to Rufus. He's gonna help me put shapes away. Have a great day.